Right, man, you ready to
right?
kill it?
Let's do it.
Totally.
Okay, here we go.
Safety checking one of the competitive options I'm going to show you later in this tabletop review. That is a CZ Scorpion Evo 3 in the Nut and Fancy project. Welcome to a feature-length review on a most interesting gun. Very interesting. There is so much to discuss about this gun. Philosophy is where the video will center.
It's a little bit different.
I've seen and read a lot of hype on this gun. I hope to ground it just a little bit. And along the way, we're going to cover all the specifics. At the end of this video, you'll have a very good idea if the CZ Scorpion Evo 3 is right for you, right for your system. By the way, it's taken me a while to get this gun. I'm not part of the launch media in the gun industry, and I relish that. I'm an outsider, fully independent. We contacted CZ USA several times for a loaner. Didn't get one. You know, you can't be guaranteed a positive review in TMP. I think some manufacturers know this. They're like, why? I'll just give it to so-and-so. I know I'll get a positive review out of him. Whatevs. We went out and bought one for y'all because I know a lot of TMPers are interested in this gun. And what I'm going to say is mostly good about this gun. There are some big downsides you really need to consider. You need to wrap your mind around this philosophy of use discussion of the CZ Scorpion Evo 3. The gun is basically a semi-auto version of the Scorpion Evo submachine gun, the Czech Scorpion Evo, specifically A1 submachine gun, is my understanding. And from what I know, it's a great subgun. Someone super smart at CZ said, hey, let's import this thing as a pistol to the US. And somehow they pulled it off. And congratulations, because it is a great addition to the gun market. Now in this video, I'm not going to go into any historical lesson on the previous versions of the Scorpion by CZ, the VZ61 for instance. Look it up if you're interested. I don't have time in this video. Too much to discuss about the Evo, which will take us right into philosophy of use. I got to get cranking on this because there's so much to discuss. First and foremost, please go and watch my video posted years ago here in the Nut and Fancy Project called Pistol Caliber Carbines, in other words, PCCs, Don't Suck After All. I still feel the same way. Have a grasp on what a pistol caliber carbine, or in this case, as it comes into the U.S. currently, a pistol can and can't do for you. Okay, a lot of people get confused on that. They go, oh, it's so awesome, you know. This is really a story about first cool and second cool when we talk about the Evo 3. And I'm not even going to go into it what that means. You should already know, by the way, because I've been talking about it forever here. Guys who were, for whatever reason, frustrated in owning an SP89, the semi-auto variant of the MP5, have a pent-up desire to own a European-style or latest-generation-style submachine gun. I totally get it. I'm kind of along those lines for second cool. It's something you've always wanted. You've dreamt about it. You've seen them in movies. Stuff I talked about in my Turkish, what was that gun? The 1894 I reviewed. I talked about it at length in that video. Same thing plays here. Guys want an MP5. They can't get it. They can't get a G36, although the G36, as I understand it, has all kinds of problems now. But you understand what I'm saying. This is a gun that will fulfill that need you have. Even in pistol form, it will do it. We're talking second cool.
Wonder how close that laser is.
Is it the absolute best pistol around? Is it the best, even if you SBR it, which we'll talk about through the video, is it the best, you know, SBR PCC? Lots of acronyms. Probably not. but it will turn you on. And it's fun for you. We've done a fair amount of shooting on this gun at this point. You're watching the video and we'll watch it throughout. It is a fun gun to shoot. Okay, now we're kind of go to first cool. What can it do for you? It's a recreational piece. Okay? Let me hit this hard. And this is what we need to kind of ground guys on. And I guess this is as good a place as any to talk about this. This is an old squad and quarantine I have, by the way. Oh, we need to put some table decorations up. New TMP patches. Order them while they're in. Ooh, shark and electric blue. That looks so cool. And orange. Sweet. They sell by themselves. I'm just throwing it out there for table decorations. You guys asked for them. We made them. Anyways, though, we're talking about how fun the gun is to shoot. It's a recreational hoot. Kind of. I told you I'm going to ground this discussion. If you're going to use this recreationally, defensively, whatever, philosophy of use, as a pistol,
I like that it's ambidextrous.
Think real hard on it. It's a 5-pound pistol. I tweeted this on my Twitter account months ago when it came out. I was like, hey, great gun, but if you do not SBR it, that is turn in a Form 1, pay the $200 so you can legally shoot it from the shoulder, you might want to think twice about it. The gun ergonomically is not set up for that. The grip angle, the safety placement, not set up to be a pistol. All they did is lop off the stock, brought it in, said, here you go. If you guys want to Form 1 it, have fun. Good on CZ. I totally applaud them for this, but it's not a comfortable pistol to shoot. I was clicking around online and I read the following quote, paraphrasing it. Natural to shoot well two-handed is what dude said. And there's probably some videos out there. Guys like, oh, it points instinctively. It's smooth. It's so fast. It's like a natural pistol. To that, I have to say, pardon my French, bullshit. It is not. It is designed as a submachine gun. It needs to have a stock to shoot well and comfortably, says me. Keeping it real. It does. I found that as a pistol, it was awkward to shoot. Whether you're extending it from two hands, whether you're doing it Secret Service-like with a single point sling. I didn't find a lot of stability in that method either. Or a target beyond 3 yards. I mean, 3 yards, who cares? Contact distance doesn't matter. But if you're shooting at 25 yards, even 15 yards, it's a handful. 5-pound pistol. That's what I'm talking about. I wish to ground the discussion on the Evo 3 along those lines. If you have no intention of SBR in it, think twice before buying it. Unless, back into the second cool discussion, you just love it for that second cool. Now, this is an SB15 SIG brace attached to it via buffer tube, via the adapter that CZ provides. You can get from them. Granted, you can shoot it arm brace style legally all day long, subject to change depending on what the ATF interpretation is going to be in the future. Who knows? I don't care. I don't know. Not my business. But you can shoot it with arm brace and it looks cool. Satisfying your need to have a sub-looking gun, granted semi-auto. Interesting, right? As a pistol, no way. Competitive options. The one I was safety checking, for instance, Springfield XD9. Hey, Nutton, you got to run either this gun as a pistol or that gun as a pistol. Which one do you choose? This one. All day long. Or, how about, you know, you're like, well, I want some more firepower. And I've shown this combination many times. Safety check. How about a Glock 34 or 35 with a full capacity magazine in it all day long? Now this gun at 25 yards, I can shoot very accurately. Don't need a stock. Compared to that one, maybe your mileage varies. I give you that. But dude, 5 pounds versus what, 26 ounces? Do the math, man. And yet this discussion is not out in the internet. I haven't seen it at all. Welcome to TMP. I mean, I just apply logic, systems logic. There it is. philosophy of use, though. Let's talk about viable options. First cool for the Evo 3, the Scorpion Evo 3. Protective detail. Would you use an S1 version? A semi-auto variation of the Scorpion? Totally could. Now, if you're LE or military, you're going to have probably access to full auto weapons, 3-round burst modes, stuff you've seen in both the news, movies, but you could. It could be a protective detail, absolutely. And in that case, you wouldn't have to fool around with a Form 1 because it's a duty firearm, agency owned. It's already going to be set up. Maybe it has an AR-15 style stock on it. Definitely is going to have 30-round mags. I think it's a great gun in that situation. Let's get back to this, though. Is it more lethal than this combination? Yeah. Slightly. 7 3/4-inch barrel versus what? 4 or 5-inch barrel, depending on your pistol of choice. Is there going to be a huge velocity difference between those? There'll be some. And no, I didn't measure it. There'll be some, and every little bit counts, especially with fast-burning defensive pistol powders. I get all that. I'm down. A little bit more lethal. But when we talk about other ready-to-go PCCs versus this one, this will hit softer than the other ones. Nice. Just by way of its barrel length. It's a short barrel. It's a sub-gun. That's what it was designed for. Protective detail, I just threw that in. It's kind of fun. Could it be used? Absolutely. Vehicle gun. Now we're kind of getting into a philosophy of use for the Evo 3 that I think is smart. It makes sense. Where quarters are extremely tight, and yet you would like to have something shoulder fired. Now, if you go watch, and you should, pistol caliber carbines don't suck after all. There's a discussion in there about hitting power. Please let this sink in. You're still shooting a 9mm. But Nutton, you don't mind carrying a 9mm. You carry it all the time. You're right. In a Glock 26. In a Car PM9. In an XDS. A subcompact, super concealable pistol. Once we go and commit to a shoulder-fired configuration for a gun, we need to kind of be smart about it. Is 9mm the best choice? That's the discussion that's in that video, by the way. I'm just kind of summarizing it here. 9mm is no powerhouse. I've always said that. It can get the job done. It does get the job done. It's very SAWC efficient. That's where my enthusiasm lies for the 9mm. I can carry a lot of rounds. It gets the job done. It's lightweight to carry. It's adequate. It's not a powerhouse. You put this gun in 10mm, then I'm much more excited about it as a shoulder-fired option. Now, we're assuming either you're an agency dude or you've SBR'd it. There might be other calibers come out, 40, 10mm, but who can shoot 10mm? I mean, for whatever POU, it's so expensive unless you just have, you know, a reloader cranking it out. I'm saying all this because you should seriously consider an AR-15 variant. Or an AK variant in a major hard-hitting rifle caliber. Suppress it if you're worried about noise. You're already going to SBR it. You're already paying a tax stamp on that. Put a can on it. Now you're complete. I would much rather run a pistol C39 from Century Arms with a can on it versus this. In pretty much most deadly force encounters. Even as a vehicle gun. Now, if you're not going to put a can on it, for whatever reason, either an agency, a military unit, granted, I don't know of any U.S. military units that use this, or will, but just for sake of conversation, we'll say that. A 9mm is probably a better choice for noise, for flash, for recoil, for blast. It's an easier gun to shoot. That's why operations groups over the years have ran the MP5. You can put a lot of rounds on target, short amount of time, very little recoil. And it also looks good on camera. It does. The MP5 looks cool, and so does this gun. The Evo 3, don't you think it presents well? If for no other reason, and I totally think this gun is going to sell. It's going to have continued sales force throughout the years, says me. I really think it will. because it gets so many things right. It is SBR a bull. Follow? It does a lot of things really well. And we haven't even got into the specifics. But hitting super hard, especially at longer distances, it isn't one of them. It's still a 9mm. I want to drive that point home. Granted, other calibers may come forth. I'm not going to redo the video. But it's a pistol caliber versus a rifle caliber. Back to vehicle gun. Low blast, low recoil. We're going to assume we have the 30-round stick in it. Good firepower, great vehicle gun. The best vehicle gun? No. If you have to go through metal, you have to go through glass, you have wood obstacles to defeat, I'd much prefer shooting a center fire rifle round. 5.56, 7.6239, 6.8 SPC. Again, you get the picture. That's why this gun is so fascinating. We have not had this particular discussion on the table before, and I'm stoked about it. Vehicle gun, protective detail, recreation, we've covered that. I think we covered second kind of cool, right? You know, there's some pent-up demand, like I said, for MP5s, other submachine guns. Guys can't legally own that. You just can't. Even if you could find one, a legal one is so astronomically priced, forget about it. Semi-auto's great. That's where a lot of guys will get super stoked about it and buy it. The Evo 3. And I'll end POU for now with this. Suppressed entry gun. I think I mentioned it super briefly at the outset. I think it would be a good, maybe not the best entry gun because of the other stuff I said. Low recoil, low blast, easily controllable, rapid fire. But I would throw a can on it, definitely have a stock on it. Great entry gun. Very short overall length, so going in tight confines of a vehicle, an apartment complex, wherever you're going around corners, good option. There's a lot of good options, really, though. If you go to an AR-15, M4 format, AK variant, you can get guns that are the same overall length, but they hit hard. End of POU, dude. That's all I'm going to say, because for time. I mean, it's fascinating. I know. Remember, still a 9mm. Go watch that other video. How about SAWC design and ergos? Let's start back here, and this is kind of jumping ahead to accessories. The gun legally can only be fired as a pistol. A lot of the testing you're seeing on video, we actually had the buffer tube unscrewed. Adapter plate on. Intentionally, we took the buffer tube off. Just to make sure we're shooting it exactly as designed, a pistol. And that's why I said it doesn't shoot great that way. One of the reasons, ergonomically speaking, and we'll just jump right here, is because the safety and the grip angle are designed as a subgun, not as a pistol. So when you try to hold this as a pistol, this safety is digging into your thumb, it's uncomfortable, the grip angle is rackish, it's really steep. Can you do it? Yeah, we did it, but it's not comfortable. Again, there's a lot of other awesome options out there if you're just going to run it as a pistol. Now, accessory-wise, SIG brace SB15, great option. But legally, you can only shoot it braced on your arm. You cannot put it up against your shoulder. All kinds of online discussions and controversy about that. I'll just leave it at that. You got to SBR it, turn in the Form 1, and pay that pretty steep $200 tax to do that. And trust me, I'm going to come back to that. And there's a reason I'm going to come back to that SBR tax. But doable. Now, this gun is going to be so popular. We're kind of jumping ahead to accessories again. Expect a whole configuration of stocks to come out. Granted, you have an AR-15 buffer tube there already. Grant, it's not, you know, indented yet. It's just smooth, this variation. But you can get it. And once you get your paperwork done, put an AR-15 or whatever other style of stock. There might be dedicated Evo 3 kits come out. Doable. Now, once you get that paperwork done, then I think, like I said in the POU discussion, the gun really comes into its own. Understand that, please. Because as a pistol, kind of a fail. As an SBR, total win. How's that? That it's as simple as that. If you understand and get that about the Evo 3, then I think you'll be extremely happy with your purchase. Okay? So all we shot is just off the arm, and I gotta tell you, it's kind of oversold. Strapping this thing across your arm, you know, provides some stability. Some of the video, you'll see me shooting without it. I'm just have my arm next to it. And then, you know, I succumb and I put it on the arm, and yeah, it provides some stability. It's just, it's kind of hokey. It's just hokey shooting that way. One, I got a massive cut on my thumb, not from a knife, from like a vise in the shop. So today I'm shooting it, and I forgot that I had that, and I'm going there, and almost ripped my flesh off. Oh, you poor baby. Well, it's just, you gotta undo the strap, put it on. It's made of heavy rubber. This thing adds like a pound to the gun. It's rubber. Maybe lighter weight polymers. More advanced stocks come out along the lines of Magpul, some other manufacturers. I'll leave it at that. Okay, so good on CZ though for making a very high quality adapter plate. It fits perfectly. It's easy to put on, easy to screw in a buffer tube. Great job. That's all I can say on there. Talked about the grip already, right? The angle, it's steep. Submachine gun like. Not a lot of traction. You could wrap it with like that Brooks Tactical A grip, put some skateboard tape on it. I believe you can swap it out as well. And I think some aftermarket parts will be made for the Evo 3 is my prediction. US made parts, which will help with 922R compliancy, by the way. I know, it's kind of a load of crap we have to deal with, but it's still out there. Put a different grip on this, more vertical, you know, better stippling. Actually, this has no stippling on it. I'd be more enthused. That'll take us to the safety. Becoming popular in the AR-15 community is a 45 degree or shorter arc throw safety. Kind of like this one has. I don't like them. I like a full 90 degree. What? That's crazy. I love my short arc safety. I don't know why I've been shooting full 90 degree throw safety so long. It's so positive to know when it's on safe. I can't change my muscle memory at this point. Sometimes I'll be shooting a gun with a short arc throw safety, for lack of a better term, and I'll look down at it. Did I throw it all the way? Once I train with that particular gun enough, I know, I'll get it. I just don't dig it. It is ambidextrous, so lefties, awesome for you. Some guys are Dremeling it to remove the sharp edges, get rid of the profile, make it narrower in profile, better said. I don't know if I'd do that. I like the shelf. When we shot it as a pistol, we're actually resting our thumb here. But the shooters did complain about its discomfort, the safety. It's positive, I like that. No doubt the A1 has, I don't even know if it's 3-round burst, but a full auto mode. Onto the trigger. It pretty much sucks. Okay, every gun has some quirks. Every gun. It's rare I bring to the table something just so perfected that I don't have anything to say about it, right? The trigger on the Evo 3, Scorpion Evo 3, is horrendous, says me. Let's put on the scale. It's gonna pull, I think, over 9. Let me beep this real quick. 9.3, we'll leave it at that. It's bad. I do not like the trigger on the Evo 3 at all. I really noticed this when I started doing accuracy testing, okay? In the field, we didn't notice it too much. Maybe we're concentrating on the target. We did a lot of night shooting with this gun. And I think I even remarked there, I was like, hey, you know, this trigger's not too bad. But then when I took it to the bench, whole different ball game. It was like, creepy. And my fingers dragging big time in the trigger guard. Big time. I was actually trying to concentrate to come up here and pull without drag to get maximum accuracy. Because the trigger is so long, so stagey, I don't know if that's the right word, but it's just stiff. We'll say that. It's just difficult to get super great accuracy without paying special attention to it. That's my takeaway from having shot this gun a fair amount. Another opportunity for US manufacturers to make a different and much better trigger pack for the Evo 3. I think you'll see that. The controls, other than safety, are pretty good. This is your bolt release. Big old paddle on the left side of the gun, none on the right. For design reasons, no doubt. Here's your magazine release. Very European-like. Just push it. I actually like that. I think once or twice during testing, because I'm really not used to the gun, I think I may come up here thinking that was a mag release. Again, it's a training issue, practice issue. So many different varieties I shoot here off and on. It's hard to keep track of everything. Flared magazine well, and the gun is pretty much polymer, and I love that. I have no issues with polymer guns. 4 second cool. You know, I think the days when guys go, oh, polymer sucked. Aren't we past that? In terms of first cool capabilities, the gun has a metal chassis. Any place that's really important, it's metal. Other than that, they went space age with it, kind of like the MP5, and made it out of polymer. MP5 was doing it back in the 60s. They figured it out. Other guns have followed suit too. I've got no issues with it. Notice the integrated sling mounts, single point or two point, whichever you want. I love those. Very cool. This one's actually for a web, so you can web something through here, sling here, and that'll take us to the Ford charging handle. Very MP5 like, with a hold open notch right here. Very cool. And so it's just fun to shoot this gun. It would be a lot funner as an SBR, no doubt. When you slap it forward, suddenly you satisfy that craving for an MP5. Yeah, it's cool. I love the non-reciprocating charging handle. Maybe this could be a little bit bigger. Maybe there's going to be some aftermarket parts coming right through there. I do have a BSA green dot on this. What? You need to put something more expensive on that, Nutton. Money's tight, dudes. I don't have money for it. And it works. For testing and review, works fine. You know, maybe we'll leave it on there. Is it the best red dot? No. Totally not. It works, though. But you don't have to put a red dot on it. You can use the pretty good sights on it. You have several apertures here in the rear. Actually, four to be exact. So you can take your pick which one you want. Sturdy ears. They're attached well. They're adjustable on the, I think, about 11-inch Picatinny rail on the top. Here's your forward sight. Pretty good. It looks very AR-15-ish, right? Well, that's what I thought too. I was like, well, I'm going to put one of my standard super thin Target AR-15 posts in there. It didn't work. And guys are probably on top of this. I didn't even look. But maybe the threading's different. So I was like, well, I got to put the stock sight back in. And then as I was screwing it in, I just couldn't get it low enough. And that is the stock CZ sight, the Scorpion Evo 3 sight. I just couldn't get it. I don't know what happened. So I take it off, send it to CZ for repair. I don't know. But I could not get full adjustment out of it. That's kind of messed up, but I don't know, you know, if it's user-induced. I would be very tempted if I'm running irons. As good as these are, I might put embus on them. Maybe micro embus. That would be cool. It'd just be cooler, you know, maybe lighten it up a little bit. I think, though, if you're going to stick to pistol configuration, especially, you should put a red dot sight on it, or, as you're seeing in our video, put a laser on it. I think a laser has limited applications. This is one of them. Can't shoulder a weapon. You're shooting it from the hip. You're shooting it from a weird angle. Laser works, and it worked for us. We made some great hits out in the desert that night with the Evo 3. Scorpion Evo 3, to be exact, with the TLR-4. And by the way, I don't think it was sighted in for the gun at the time. So if you're wondering, hey, why are they aiming there? It was swapping back between several different guns. We just slapped it on. That's why. And this is a light as well. Light laser combination for this. It's just in laser mode right now, though. That's what you should aim your gun with, says me, especially in pistol configuration. Aiming it with iron sights pistol configuration, it was just tough. Enough said. Love the Picatinny rails. All three sides, lots of options, and the fore end is actually, although integral, pretty thin. You can put pretty much whatever accessory you want on it. This comes already. The forward hand stop, and that is needed. With a short gun like this, it would be real easy to have your hand slip forward and you blow your fingers off. Be super careful. Until you SBR it, you can't put a VG on it. Another reason I would love to SBR this, we still may. Still may. Be cool. And that takes us to the proprietary threaded 7 3/4 inch, by the way, drop forged barrel, which is cool, and flash suppressor. I actually love the looks of it. I think it worked okay. I did no scientific testing on it, but it has a weird threading. Expect to see adapters come out for this gun so guys can put a can on it. If and when they want to do that, they fill out the paperwork, all that stuff, blah, blah, blah. I would probably just run it as is. It looks great. Very short overall length. If and when you want to suppress it, just get an adapter. They'll be coming out by someone. Do it then. Design, ergos. The weight, actually, as a rifle or subgun alternative, is pretty light. Very light. As a pistol, not so much. Does that make sense? I hope so, because that's what we're talking about. It's a straight blowback design, and we might as well just do field strip right now. Okay, and I've only done it one other time, but it seemed pretty super simple. Safety check it, safe direction, lock it into the locking notch here. Here's your push pin right there. Okay, and it's captive as well, so it won't fall out. Nice job, CZ. And then pull this trigger assembly out like so. There you go. So will U.S. manufacturers come out with a new trigger? I think they will. I think there's going to be so many of these out there. It'll be extremely popular. You'll see it. And they can get rid of that horrible trigger pull. And who knows? Maybe a gunsmith could work that over and make it awesome. I don't know. Now that gives an opportunity to look inside the bolt. There's your reciprocating blowback bolt. It's massive. And I've taken it apart, as you can see from my greasy hands, earlier tonight. And I'm impressed with the quality of construction. Steel rails, the springs used. I don't look at anything in this gun and say, yeah, that's cheap. Nothing. If you want to take the bolt out, I think you just kind of pop it just a little bit forward. There we go, like that. Out comes the bolt. Right there. See it? Recoil guide assembly. Look how big that bolt is, man. Blowback. It's got to be big enough to, you know, to withstand probably plus P pressures. And incidentally, we did shoot 158 grain loads with this. Just put that back into the notch. Charging handles set up. Freak. There we go. Like that right there. And it was reliable with 158 grain loads. So that's pretty cool. In fact, it was reliable with all the loads shot except for one, jumping ahead to reliability. Somewhere along the way, we did have some malfunction. I may show it. I'm not going to ever edit that out. It is what it is. Don't know why it happened. I think it happened with Jardine. Firepower, moving right along. Fun review, by the way. Love this review. 20 rounds currently, probably 30 rounds later. Jam. And I really love these magazines, incidentally. They remind me of the old 1980s Sig 550 series mags, which I used to lust after. I used to look at those mags in a pawn shop, Van Wagenen's, and go, man, those are great mags. They're super light. They're translucent. You can see the rounds. They're made well. Removable base plate. No metal feed lips. I'm talking the Sig 550 series. And this is the same way. It seems to be a really nice magazine. It's easy enough to load. It seems durable, time will tell. We need 30 rounders. I think they're going to be relatively inexpensive when they come out. And again, jumping ahead to accessories, US manufacturers may make them. Major manufacturers may make them. That way you have another US made part for, again, 922R compliance. Love the magazines. Let's stop right here though, before we get too carried away. Right now, 20 rounds, later 30 rounds, for the Scorpion, right? Let's bring this back, please, so we can just remember this. The Glock 34 with a 33 round mag. Again, if you're not SBRing it, I would take this all day long. I gotta mention that. And a lot of magazines are readily available for this gun. You can buy currently, subject to whatever the protectionists end up passing. Great job, by the way, gun guys, preventing all that to this point. all day long you can buy 33 rounders for your Glock. You don't have to wait at all. That's a lot of firepower, and they're reliable, and they work. So back to the Evo, you know, Scorpion Evo. Yeah, how long are you going to wait till you get those? I don't know. Just a thought. I'll give firepower once the 30 rounders get here a solid A. Track record, we talked about. One jam, the rest was total perfection. And to be totally honest, I would expect as much from basically a pistol caliber carbine, albeit in pistol configuration. It's a huge bolt. It's blowback configuration. It's as simple as it gets. It should be reliable. The thing I guess we should give it kudos for is being reliable with a bunch of different bullet weights. I fired 115 grains all the way up to 158s, and that, by the way, brings us right to accuracy. My overall take for the Scorpion Evo 3 is that it is good accuracy, perhaps at times outstanding, as evidenced by this. I think these are tacticalammunition.com's 115 grain FMJs, which, by the way, is an extremely accurate load. I've always said that, and it is. Here's shooting with nothing but the freaking laser. Indoor range with the arm brace. I put a note on there. That shows you that a laser does and can work. Granted, it's from a bench, but hello, that's pretty good. 25 yards rested. This is TAC A again, Tactical Ammunition. That's a great group. Just shooting with a laser at 25 yards, and that's as far out as I went. Incidentally, I think of this as a very short range gun. 50 yards or closer is how I think of it. I think I've said that with all the PCCs I've brought to the table, right? Definitely inside 100 yards. Once you go past 100 yards, forget it. Hey, I could hit it 300 yards with it. Yeah, but how much energy are you going to have with that little 9mm when you do? 7 3/4 inch barrel. Think about it. Again, getting back to it, the rifle caliber. That's where I'm going to go. Good accuracy here. CZ Scorpion. This is this month. Waist fired. You know, you'll see footage of us goofing around that way, just shooting it from the waist. It works. You can train that way and get pretty good at it. You don't have to make it into an SBR. You can just shoot it from the waist. Doable. Look at the accuracy. That's 10 yards is all, but still. Would you recommend that, Nutton? Honestly, I wouldn't. No, I think it's kind of hokey. I think aimed fires where you want. You start aiming from the waist, what else happens? You send around where you don't want it to? Forget it. This is Fiocchi 115 grain today. Jacket and hollow point. Gets better from there. Another target. Going as fast as I can. 115 grain. Remington JHP. American Eagle. That was FMJ. That's a good grouping for FMJ out of this gun. Good grouping. I did notice in some groups it had a tendency to throw around with good trigger pulls. I felt good about the trigger pulls. And by the way, this is shooting with a BSA red dot. 3 MOA variety. I like it, by the way. It's a good dot for the money. Fiocchi, 158 grain subsonic. I wasn't too impressed with that group. I thought it would shoot better. There's 115, Remington's again. Look at that group. This one right here. 115 Remingtons, and then there's that flyer I'm talking about. I would say it's me, but it pretty much manifested itself in most groups, so that's not me. That's the gun. American Eagle FMJ, 3 rounds. I think this is 1, 2, 3, 4 with a flyer. 1, 2, 3 with a flyer. That's FMJ loading. Look at this group, though. Fiocchi, this round is so excellent. Fiocchi 124 grain JHP. It's always shot so well, but look at that. It still has a flyer. Instead of one hole, 1, 2, 3. See what I'm saying? It just has a tendency for that. 3-round group with American Eagle, 3-round with Fiocchi, FMJ. I'm sorry, that's a jacket of hollow point load, and that's the best group right there. So I would say good to excellent for the accuracy. Now it's time to bring in a competitive option. I guess this, we might as well just do it here. You guys will love this. It's interesting and it's fun. Of course, you know we have to bring in a pistol caliber carbine, which I think is extremely high value, very capable, previously reviewed. I've talked about it lots, shown it lots. Kel-Tec Sub 2K. Okay, we're just talking about accuracy here. That level of accuracy you just saw there, this gun will meet or exceed it. Go watch my review. Go watch, what was it, Eat Lead Drills that we did with the gun. Okay, so I would say it's on par. I would maybe give the edge to the Sub 2K. It should be more accurate because it has a much longer barrel. Speaking of which, makes it more lethal. Nice. Said that in the Kel-Tec review as well. The new Sub 2K is even better than this gun. Has some cool improvements. I haven't shot it yet, but I think it's going to be pretty styling. Again, if you can find them. They sell so quickly. Think about what we said, though. Philosophy of use. We're leaving accuracy, by the way. Lethality. Legality. I didn't mean to put those two words together, but they match. Okay, we can get a Sub 2K for, in the end, a lot less than this gun. The Sub 2K, and I'm just using the Sub 2K as an example. We've kind of morphed into competitive options. We could throw in a Just Right carbine there. Maybe an Uzi pistol. I'm not really super fond from anything that fires from an open bolt. And some others. Marlin Camp, 1894s. And most of them are just going to be ready to go out of the box like the Kel-Tec Sub 2000. You don't have to worry about SBR paperwork. You don't have to worry about 922R. It's going to have a longer barrel, more lethal, perhaps more accurate. It's just a turnkey PCC. Think about it. Unless you have a super craving for an MP5 style PCC, you might be better off with a Sub 2000. Or a Shorty AR. Or a Shorty AK and SBR those. Okay? I'll just leave it at that. Competitive options, though. Here's one you may not have thought of. And I seriously consider it as a competitive option. And because it is so funny, it's going to take you by surprise. Say hello again to the M1 carbine. You did not see that one coming, did you? The M1 carbine against the CZ Scorpion Evo 3? What? Absolutely. It's going to fire a harder hitting caliber, albeit it's anemic in terms of rifles, but in terms of pistols, not so much. You know, it's a little bit more powerful than a 9mm, right? And you can get magazines for this one quite readily in 30 round configuration. It doesn't have that cool MP5-ish presence that the Scorpion Evo has. I get that. But again, just like the Sub 2K, there's no SBR hassles, there's no outrageous $200 tax stamp. Maybe in some localities it will stay legal longer because it's considered an antique by some. M1 carbine, great option. It just depends on what you're looking for. Now, overall length, not even a comparison. I get that. Versatility, not even a comparison. No Picatinny rails on this one. But sometimes simple's better. The sights on the M1 carbine work great. No way to attach a lighter laser, though. Just a thought. The gun currently is running around $750 to $800 if you can find them. I'm sure the gun stores will start stocking and getting your desired CZ Scorpion Evo 3. It's a matter of time. And I think, by the way, backing up just a little bit, we talked about most accessories. The stock, the pistol grip, the magazines, the trigger, sight options for sure. How about cases? Well, I've just been running this old Eagle case flat that I bought back in 1987. I've had this since 1987. Closed cell foam, it works great. Maybe a little bit too long for the gun. Works good though. Slings. I was just using, it's kind of stuck over here. Here it comes. Just a simple KZ single point sling. You've seen me using it in the video and clipping it into that very cool single point sling ring right there. All kinds of slings you can get. Mag clamps. Those will probably be made available. I don't know if they'll count as a 922R part. Maybe they will, maybe they won't. Clamp two mags together. Again, looks just like an MP5. Some guys will really love that. The thing you really need to consider for accessories, and I'm going to end the video here in just a second, is that $200 Form 1 if you want to SBR it. That's a lot of money, and it really kind of ruins the value equation when you compare it to the alternatives for first cool. So now we have about a $1,000 gun versus whatever Kel-Tec sub-2Ks are going for in your locality. Think about it. M1 carbine, any others, you have to throw that out there. I would probably put some embus on it, but the stock sights are fine. Other accessories, you can figure it out. Got to wrap it up, dudes. Overall, remember what I said. This is a two-personality, two-decision gun. If you're going to run it as a pistol, I would think very hard about that decision. It's a 5-freaking-pound pistol in 9mm. I said that about the SP89, dudes. My friends and I talked about that gun all the time. Like, hey, man, it's a great gun. I was like, yeah, it's kind of cool. But it's really expensive, and it's still heavy as a pistol. You know, and they're like, yeah, I still love it. Okay, then you're talking second, cool. But as a pistol? Dudes, I would choose a freaking Canik TP9 SA. 8 ways from Sunday over that as a pistol. 18 plus 1? $340? That's like one-third the price of that. Think about it. Kel-Tec Sub-2K, awesome. Nice. Proven in TMP, very reliable. With brass case. Don't shoot aluminum case in it, but you run with brass case. It runs all day long. Very accurate, too. Fun to shoot.
Thanks, bro.
I don't know. It's still a great gun. So as a pistol, I think it sucks. As an SBR, I think it rules. Very short overall length. It's extremely reliable. Has a great level of accuracy. It's very cool, very lightweight. Within the constraints of the caliber, we talked about that, 9mm, it can be deadly. Lots of different philosophies of use. But that's the way the gun is designed to be ran, with a shoulder stock, put in the paperwork, or think real hard about the pistol configuration. Nut and Fancy tabletop review complete. See ya.